For decades, land mobile radio, also known as two-way radio or LMR, has been the mainstay of mobile critical communications. Operating in licensed frequencies and used by millions worldwide in countless different conditions, constantly tested and refined, it has been the yardstick of success for critical communications, particularly in public safety. From the start, LMR was geared for voice communications. As a result, it has all the voice services that critical communications users expect, including individual group and broadcast calls, emergency calls, various types of call prioritization, call preemption, simplex, and so forth. To make a call, a user presses a push-to-talk or PTT button, speaks, and then releases the button to put the radio into receive mode. This type of operation is considered essential for critical communications. In dangerous or high-pressure situations, you want to be connected as quickly and simply as possible. LMR equipment has some of the best coverage of any wireless communications technology, with very large cell sizes, measured in tens of miles or kilometers. This coverage can be extended using a network of tall, high-power towers so that radio systems can be created to cover cities, states, and even whole nations. However, that excellent coverage also has a cost. High-powered mobile radios need lots of power and consequently are fitted with big batteries. That is why 5-watt police portables with an 11-hour 5590 duty cycle look as big as they do. It takes more battery power to go farther, harder, longer. Modern LMR technologies such as DMR, P25, Tetra, and NXDN are all open standard and, being digital, can operate over standard IP networks. It also enables LMR to carry a certain amount of data in addition to voice. LMR communications have an outstanding reputation for reliability built on the ruggedness of LMR equipment and on the numerous fail-safe options built into LMR radios and networks. And through its close association with public safety, security options have been developed for LMR systems, including military-grade encryption of all the voice and data transmissions. On the downside, LMR is an inefficient user of scarce radio spectrum, so professional organizations sometimes struggle to find available frequencies. One consequence is that spectrum authorities have reduced LMR bandwidth in order to squeeze more users into limited spectrum. As a result, data transmission has suffered. LMR can only offer low-capacity data in its limited bandwidth, which is okay for short text-oriented data services, but rules out high-bandwidth data applications such as streaming video. It comes as no surprise, then, that LMR users have looked for another barrier to access broadband data.